There's a forested valley on the other side of the city, once teeming with wildlife. It's now dead. The royal delegations arrived here that way.
I know. That's why we went around. What exactly killed the Vrans?
As the years went by and the climate turned colder, the Vrans had less and less food. Their hunters descended to the lowlands, where they encountered the first human settlers and their plagues, typhus, dysentery, and pneumonia. The Vrans began to fall ill. They tried to save themselves, building an aqueduct and sewers that rivaled today's. But it grew colder, and the canal...
We're in Lockween.
We're on the fringes somewhere. We should find what we came for nearer the main quarters.
Let's go.
They gagged Philippa in the nick of time. She almost cast a spell. Rotting in the Redanian dungeon now, in special shackles.
Radovid's right to show the witches their place.
I wonder what they'll do to her. Either the executioner or the monsters will have their fun. They say Logmoin's dungeons are full of scum of all kinds.
No idea what they locked her up for, but every sorceress is guilty of something.
True enough. Not likely to see anyone weeping for her.
A dungeon befits Philippa Eilhart very well, though gallows would be even better.
If they killed her, you can forget about healing Saskia.
They must guard her as heavily as the Emperor's bedchamber. We'll not get in there.
I'm in no hurry to visit the Emperor's bedchamber, but we've got to get into the dungeon.
Look for a passage through the sewers. I'll locate Eilhart's quarters. If she didn't expect to be arrested, I may find something interesting there.
The tunnels beneath the city sound reasonable.
They used to lead almost everywhere, though some passages may have collapsed during the fires.
It's still worth a shot.
Let's go then.
I'll find Philippa. You search her quarters.
Right. We learned a lot the last time we browsed through her things. Va fail, Gwynblade.
I knew we'd meet again.
Not you.
Silgrat doesn't forget humiliation.
What do you want?
You won't win this time. All of Edirne will know the power of Silgrat's fist. Stand and fight. Be off! Oh, the fucking shame. Yes?
The mages will be overjoyed if you sign their treaty. Any idea who'd be the advisor in Vengerberg?
They insist on appointing the advisor themselves, though I doubt Saskia will accept that.
Anything can happen.
That lass will allow no one to control her. I've been observing her. She's a splendid commander.
Making her even more dangerous if anyone manages to manipulate her.
I'm not sure I understand.
Just thinking aloud. I guess you're here about the war with Kedwin.
They wouldn't let us near Natalis, and Radovid refuses an audience. Scandalous. The mages drone on about their coven of advisors, but even they don't take us seriously. Perhaps the prince could get something, but I'm not certain they'll let him into the talks. Henselt protested, and the others are too cowardly to stand up to him. As a result, we are not officially here.
Henselt can't openly interfere in your matters.
Who's to stop him? He claims the prince is preparing to set a dangerous precedent by eradicating serfdom.
Terrible crime. Next thing you know, he'll do away with court protocol.
What can I do for you?
Do you play dice?
Would you like to join us?
Another time.
Welcome.
Hey! What?
Welcome.
Hey! Watch it!
tiny bit.
Your Majesty.
I've waited long for this meeting. You left Redania so suddenly I had no chance to give you the send-off you so richly deserved.
Your Majesty, I fail to understand why I have been arrested. I've done nothing but serve Redania's interests, supporting the rebellion, undermining Henselt, risking my own reputation on your behalf.
I'm no longer the little boy who believed your every word.
Why do you do this, Radovid? I was there at your most trying hours. Without me, you would not be the man you are. I don't understand.
You understand very well.
You conspired against my father, Vizimir, and against me. The entire Redanian court once trembled in fear of Philip Ryleheart.
Untrue, sire. You must let me explain. What are your charges, Your Majesty?
Ambassador.
Triss Marigold was kind enough to compile a list of persons making up the secret society known as the Lodge of Sorceresses. Some Nilfgaardian sorceresses were members as well, but you need not be bothered with them, my lady.
Triss, you're mad!
The Lodge ordered Demoven killed. It ordered Foltes killed. I suspect you played a part in my father's death. And if I released you from the Dimeritium, you'd kill me too. You're finished, Ryleheart. There will be a trial, due process, everything as it should be. But know that you shall not wriggle out of this. You shall be convicted of conspiracy, treason, and regicide. They'll rip your flesh from you in bits before they burn you at the stake. Throughout my childhood, I felt your cold stare on the back of my neck. When I issued orders, My subjects would search with their eyes for Philippa Eilhart's gesture of consent. The entire court at Tretagor looked on as you humiliated me. All Redania laughed behind my back. You taught me to look everyone in the eye. Force them to lower their gaze, do you remember? A king must never show weakness, uncertainty, you said. I've mastered that skill. Yet there is one I could never force to submit. You. You've one chance to shorten your suffering. Admit to everything, here and now, in the Ambassador's presence. Look me in the eye and repent. Submit. As you wish. Torturer. Put out those vile eyes.
You're making a grave error, sire.
We will talk again, witch.
The Philippa Eilhart problem has been resolved. We must return to camp.
Wait here, Excellency. We'll scout ahead.
Long live the Emperor!
Look what they did to me. Radovid. To think I taught him magic tricks when he was just a boy. Free me, Geralt. I have to get out of here. Do you hear me? Help me!
You'll answer a few questions first. Was Schiller telling the truth about the Lodge, the assassinations?
He said exactly what Radovid wanted to hear. Half-truths, musings stripped of context, which differ very little from lies.
Did Triss take part in all this?
She's clean in those terms. Innocent as a child, but only to a point. I assure you, she has not been honest with you about many other matters.
Why did all this happen? Murdering monarchs, what interests did it serve? I can't fathom.
Help me get out of here and I'll explain all and lift the spell from Saskia. Take these shackles off me and lead me to my house. I beg you. I'll tell you everything. Everything!
I didn't track you alone. Yorvith can't wait to see you again.
My death would change little. Yorvith and all like him have no right to judge others.
How does the spell work?
Saskia's will and mine are one. She cannot resist me. But fear not. There's no suffering involved. She merely believes me to be the most wonderful person in the world, as if she were in love. You know what's most beautiful? In spite of all this, she seems unchanged. She's retained her charm, her valor, her honor.
Where's Saskia?
When I was arrested, she was with Sheila. They must be on their way to the deliberations by now.
Clock's ticking. Time is of the essence.
Why do you do this? Would you take vengeance on a blind woman?
Shillard said they've got Triss. I have to free her before they put out her eyes, too.
Going to the Nilfgaardian camp is suicide.
And leaving a friend is villainy.
Only I know how to break the spell that holds Saskia. Get me out of here. If I die, she'll remain forever spellbound.
All right, but if you're lying to me...
Unbind me and lead the way. We must return through the sewers.
The shackles stay on, and you'll go first.
Shillard will raise the alarm.
No, he won't. We'll be long gone by the time he comes to.
Kill him.
I'm not into murdering unconscious old men. Lead on. No tricks, Phil.
I want to get out of here, and I want to...
Can you walk? Sure you won't faint on me?
I'll manage. Will you remove my shackles?
The manacles stay on.
Did this to her.
It was Radovid's way of thanking her for the care she provided him when he was a child.
I saw him with his army on his way to the talks, whistling a tune.
Get me out of here!
Shut up, witch! You're alive only because you're still needed.
Philip has promised to help us in exchange for her freedom.
And you believe her?
Know a better way to free Saskia? What state is Saskia in now?
I've ordered her to carry out Sheila's bidding until I return.
Great. And Sheila will be at the docks?
Yes. She's probably there already, making certain the Lodge's plans do not fall through.
What would you have done if Saskia hadn't been poisoned? If a certain foolish witcher hadn't gathered the potion ingredients?
I would have sought other means, but I couldn't miss that opportunity.
What's Sheila supposed to safeguard?
The restitution of the Council and Conclave, and the creation of a strong, independent state with Saskia as its leader.
With what aim?
As a bulwark. A defense against Nilfgaard. After years of chaos and destruction, the time has come to build. We wish to rule, yes. Where is the fault in that? Everyone wants to rule. And I know how to do that. Better than any other monarch in this city.
You can't hope to win the common folk's trust. Humans will never accept a sorceress queen.
Non-humans won't either, given what that old hag Finderbear has achieved.
They all believe in Saskia. They all trust her. The girl is a born leader, yet she has no political instincts. She's charismatic, but not cunning. Courageous, but not fierce. She is just, but lacks the required cruelty.
She is your very opposite.
Perhaps. Together we would be unstoppable.
Did you order Foltest murdered?
No!
Shillard claimed that Triss testified.
Triss doesn't know what she's talking about. The Lodge exists, and Triss has lost our trust. All that is true. But Foltest's assassination? That was not my order.
How do we free Saskia?
I have charmed a dagger with a counterspell. You must thrust it into the She-Dragon's heart.
You mean your heart, witch? Do you mock us?
There is no other way. She must be struck with surgical precision, otherwise the counterspell won't work. All the blade's runes must touch blood, and its point must pierce a chamber of her heart.
We'll need to hold her down somehow.
Hold down a dragon? This is ridiculous! She's lying, Geralt. I don't trust her. Why would she even need this dagger? In a minute we'll hear that she planned to free Saskia herself.
Any time you cast a spell or a curse, you must have a counterspell at the ready. It's a basic rule of magic. I prepared the dagger just before I cast the spell, in case anything went awry.
A basic rule, but I don't know many mages who follow it. Where's the dagger?
My quarters. In Geoffrey Monk's former home, inside a well-secured chest.
I know the house.
Yoveth, know any way to get to Philippa's quarters unnoticed?
Through this sewer. We may encounter monsters, but we'll gain a lot of time.
Keep an eye on her. I'll go ahead.
There's something in there. I avoided this place earlier.
Knowing you, it's probably a damsel in distress. That's all right.
Saskia perishes from the blow. You'll be next. And be assured, it will not be a quick death.
Stench too.
Pain-killing spells require focus and precision.
Die from the pain, then. Rest assured, no one will help you, nor weep for you. Keep moving. Geralt, you'd best check the room before we enter. I don't like this.
Neither do I.
I can help you.
Shut up.
Mm-hmm.
Is this the chest?
Describe it.
It's heavy, covered in runes. There's a circle and candles on the floor.
Yes. The very chest in which Geoffrey Monk kept his most valuable treasures. The dagger's inside.
How do we bloody open it?
The candles must be lit in a specific order. I figured it out. My notes are downstairs. After that, a simple spell will suffice. Remove my shackles.
Geralt, do you know this ritual?
Only a mage can perform it.
Shut up!
I'll light the candles, then we'll remove the dimeridium. Nothing's happening.
My notes are clear. Now unshackle me. I'll open the chest with a spell.
Neither of us can utter it.
It's not something you learn in a moment. A trained mage is needed to cast spells. The candles are lit. We need to hurry. Do as I say before I lose consciousness.
Try anything clever and you will die.
Lift the spell binding her, but she will never be human.
She's more than a Dwan. Someone who restored hope to the Enshay.
She's a monster. If you think she can rule a realm of humans and elves herself...
Face it, Delian!
You'll suffer the consequences of your foolishness!
Look out, Geralt! Amazing fight, Gwynblade! Get the dagger and let's get out of here!
Let's hope this blade will do the trick.
A strange weapon. Never seen anything like it. I hope it works. Too bad Isleheart won't tell us anything more.
Keep in mind that the other sorceresses are here. Philippa may inform Sheila.
Or command the dragon.
I won't be surprised if I'm forced to fight Saskia. Confused by spells, she won't understand we want to help her.
You're probably right. But
please, don't kill her. Unless you must do so to save your own life.
Philippa will be far away by now. She was in pain. Let's hope that kept her honest.
She's bound to recover quickly and promptly return to conspiring.
She's out of the game for now. Time to join the talks.
I'll go ahead and see what we can expect.
Magic, I tell you! Shatter your towers and crystal balls! Break your wands and burn your hats! Turn away the black cat! And the bat, the owl, and the rat.
Greetings.
Likewise.
It's a brazen attack.
Greetings. Nice place.
Many thanks for the compliment. Welcome to the Eternal Fire.
Kitchen open day and night.
It's not that kind of fire. The Eternal Fire is the light of truth, the hearth of a true community. Only in the Eternal Fire beneath the sign of this clan can we burn witches all day, and man is fellow man. Where's my amulet against liberals?
Radovid sent them, you idiot!
The audacity!
Pull yourself together! Hmm? Take care.
Witcher.
Greetings.
I'm Geralt.
Brass of Bannard. I remember you from Thanard. I believe I saw you in Oxenfurt, too.
Seems we only ever meet on Elvenland.
Indeed. But I suspect you're not here to chat about Elven ruins.
Actually, I'm here because of your weapon expertise.
I'm no expert.
You're the best swordsmith among mages.
I'm more interested in the cultural relics of other races, actually.
I'm going to need a solid cultural relic in my hand.
I guess the circumstances require haste.
Tell me what you know about those gargoyles that are bothering you.
They were servants of the mages who once lived in Loch Muin. The mages left, but the gargoyles remained behind. They're still lethal. The quarters they guard are simply inaccessible.
I'm interested in the Wild Hunt. Any chance you know something about it?
No. Birds are not exactly my speciality.
Thanks. I came upon this strange manuscript. Think you can help me with it?
Why, yes. I don't believe I'm mistaken.
Do you realize what you hold in your hands?
I wouldn't be asking if I did.
You see, the Vrans knew well how to secure their treasures. It is said that in some places they left sentries. Now, these sentries come to life when someone draws near who possesses a scroll inscribed with words of power, like this one is. Provide the correct password, and the doors to a hidden vault open before you.
So how do I use the manuscript?
Nothing comes free, my friend. You needn't even know the meaning of the words for the sentry to let you pass. You must merely know the sequence in which the password must be read. In this case, we have a sentence. Nana Kanpa zi udu ya lala gat exa nana zi udu zi gat kanpa nibit. Nana Kanpa means forge ahead, while Nana zi means backtrack. In summary, should you encounter a sentry who reacts to this scroll, you must first answer with the words that follow Nana Kanpa in their given sequence, then omit Nana Z, and conclude with all the words that follow this phrase, but in reverse order.
Not that complicated, actually. Thanks for your help.
Now you tell me. I don't work with sorceresses. This is no job for me.
What's going on? Are you about to fight?
The Conclave has forbidden dueling.
You can't just back out. We agreed. We have commitments to fulfill.
You did take an advance on your fee.
And I'm keeping it. Don't you follow me.
Witcher Geralt, a sight for sore eyes you are. May we speak?
Didn't expect to see you again. Certainly not here.
Loch Mween is an intriguing place.
For scientists especially.
We've mounted a small expedition and require protection.
What kind of expedition are we talking about?
We have irrefutable evidence that Ebde Henna's laboratory is located in Loch Mween.
We need an armed man to protect us from the filth in the sewers. They're infested with monsters.
The details you'll get from our employer.
A sorceress.
Tell you what, I'll catch up to you when I'm ready. Where will I find you?
We're off to the Crypt of Maid.
It's beneath that tower.
So, are you a sorceress now?
It's not that simple. A pass is simply not enough. But Philippa Eilhart summoned me here for an important exam, so I hope to be one soon.
An exam?
A secret one. I'm not even sure how to prepare. I'm cramming intensely, everything bit by bit, just to be sure.
Good luck. Still willing to sell me potions and herbs?
I'm a student, aren't I? Every little copper counts.
Thank you.
freak!
Welcome.
You lose, Sonic.
Are you the mighty Numa?
Who's asking?
Someone who wants to see if your nickname suits you.
Then come to the circus and watch me rip off the plowing chains wrapped round my body.
You've got a big mouth.
And you've pissed off the mighty Numa. Put down your coin and give me your hand.
I've always been the curious sort.
They say witches are...
Scalen Burden told me you cheat.
And you believe that stinking midget?
It's you I don't believe. Fact is, you could only get that kind of strength from potions.
Fuck you! You're as loaded with potions as squirrel shit is with gnats!
I was clean during our bout. You're a con. They should call you Numa the Cheater.
One more word and I'll shove your tongue so deep down your throat it'll come out your arsehole!
How will you do that? You'll lose your coordination when you're headless.
Why the aggro? I don't need any aids. I'm still the best without them.
Let me guess.
Behold, the mighty Numa! And I am his apprentice.
Way to spoil my fun.
The mighty Numa breaks the necks of bulls, bends iron bars, defeats everyone. Numa. His secret lies in the mushrooms and herbs cultivated in Ilanda and picked in the mornings by virgin priestesses. They can be yours for a very reasonable price.
You can only...
You a thief.
I don't have to steal. I kick everyone's ass when it comes to arm wrestling. Care to try me?
I've always been the curious sort.
To those ticks! No one's ever beaten me!
There's always a first time.
If I give you something, will you keep this to yourself? The circus finds out I lost, they'll can me. The mighty Numa must be invincible. Take this and keep your trap shut. Please.
All right. Thanks.
be broken through in the right spot!
Quiet.
Stand ready. He killed Vanimar.
And many other mages. I know who he is, Cynthia.
In the same city as Philippa, and you didn't even bother to change your name. That takes balls.
Philippa's out of the picture. She's been arrested.
And I was supposed to die, but I didn't. Grave error.
I'll make you a deal.
You don't get it. You turned Triss into a cold stone. I'm having a hard time trying to figure out why I shouldn't turn you into a cold corpse.
She is alive and well. We decompressed her successfully. There were no complications.
And the interrogation after she was decompressed? Because you did interrogate her.
I personally supervised it. We presented the tools, gave her a few bruises, and that sufficed to get her to talk.
Tools? A few bruises? You really don't want to leave this crypt alive.
If we're to die, we'll do so proudly, serving the Emperor. But I think that unlikely. Contrary to what they say, you're no murderer. Triss told me so.
Got anything else to tell me?
Just one thing. I've supervised dozens of interrogations. All subjects talk sooner or later. That's an old truth. Though some resist longer than others. Triss Merigold did not resist at all. She grew pale at the mere sight of the saws, hooks, and needles. She was prepared to talk before the interrogation began.
What did she tell you?
I will not betray the Emperor.
I'm no good at interrogating others. Tell me, or I'll cut your hands off.
The Lodge of Sorceresses. We know its members. Margarita Loantil, Francesca Findebert, Fringilla Vigo.
Skip it. I'm not interested.
The assassinations of the kings. Philippa and Sheila de Tansaville commissioned them.
What else?
I don't know anymore. The subject needed to recover after the first session.
How can I get into the Nilfgaardian camp?
There's one entrance. Beyond it, a long, heavily guarded corridor. You can't hope to sneak in. Renwald Mattson chose the spot specifically to avoid being surprised.
Where are you holding Triss?
At the back of the camp, beneath a ruined building.
You're gonna help me free her.
Not likely. You're better off killing me now. You've no idea what the Emperor's intelligence apparatus does to turncoats.
Why are you here?
We suspect Der Henna's laboratory may contain documents and books that could be useful to the Imperial Academy of Science.
That wasn't even close to funny. You're lying.
We don't know what's inside. Der Henna was a talented man, but also an eccentric.
What do you hope to find?
That's confidential. I cannot tell you. Regardless, we need your help. The laboratory lies beneath the Redanian camp, which we cannot penetrate above ground. We want to get there through the sewers, but can't manage it without a capable swordsman.
Any deals we make will not be on your terms.
Hear me out.
So be it.
Witcher, help me complete my mission. Help me open Der Henna's laboratory.
What'll you give me?
I've read the intelligence reports. I know your past. There are things in there, important things you don't remember.
I could force you to tell me.
I don't think so. Will you torture me? We both know you couldn't.
Fine. I'll help you open the laboratory.
In exchange, I'll tell you all I can. Do we have a deal?
Yeah. One more thing.
We made a deal!
I'm even faster with my sword. No tricks.
Are we likely to encounter drowners? Or a related species? Perhaps other monsters?
That is how this world's built. Sewers are infested with monsters.
No rats are running around sewers. What we're looking for, anyway? Some graves, I heard.
Graves? So maybe there is something in this forest.
Shut your traps. Want the sergeant to hear? You've been deep shot. But it is a good idea.
We've got company. Redanian bastards.
Entrance must be somewhere here.
If our experts are to be trusted.
Der Henna dabbled in illusions, among other things.
He also experimented heavily with golems.
Golems with the power of speech, supposedly. They knew nothing of poetry, but...
Will you two shut up?
Yes, it's an illusion. I found a weak spot. Stand back!
Oh,
later. Later, Elorn. Lisa, Elorn. Later, dear!
At times I'm caught. You can get my kind of feet. Though I have no needles, they say I am piercing. What am I?
Careful with the answer. It could be a trap.
Typical of dear Henna. He was a genius with a penchant for mischievous jokes. Like a child.
So a couple of adults, purported experts, should have no problem solving this.
Indeed, it's trivial. The answer is pain.
Incorrect.
No! Impossible! So many years of research together. Why did we ever embark on this? Imagine the books, the potions...
We must go on.
Let's get this over with quickly.
Poor friend.
I'm seen to fly, described as hard. I can be your currency and heal all wounds, but not many things can stand my test.
What do you think? Just keep it serious this time. We don't need another corpse.
I think it's a feather. Lifted high into the air by the wind, it can appear to fly.
I was a mistress of riddles at the age of 10, but I've never heard of feather money or of fluff being a test of anything. The sun might work.
It appears to fly, can be punishing. It's minted on Nilfgaardian florins, and surviving it in the Korath Desert is a man's ultimate test. Fits nicely. What if it's death? A metaphor for death.
Master Farid reveals his poetic soul. Touching. Too bad all the solutions are unlikely.
What do you suggest? Time? The Redanian eagle? A toothless vampire? Perhaps the Witcher has a better idea.
The sun.
Incorrect.
Imagine the books, the potions. Oh, poor friend.
Let's get this over with quickly.
We must go on.
Please repeat the riddle.
Pleasant or terrible, I come at night or in daytime, short or long, but yours alone, essential, I am.
A dream.
Correct.
It's going rather well so far.
Not for everybody. Someone's been here, recently.
I persuaded Gaspar.
I expected a greater challenge. Thus far, we've had but riddles fit for beer enthusiasts.
Too bad about Gaspar.
Well, well, the competition's here. Kill them!
Ah!
must have descended straight from their quarter.
Bled a Nordling.
Another Guardian.
Wandering through the dark. Three guides above them, so three were marked. At night they trailed a drake serpentine and a silver lady shining and fine. If only her visage she would deign to unfold. By day they followed a mountain vault, its riches untold.
Did I hear someone complain about the riddles being too easy?
Let's think this through. There are 9 alcoves, a fresco in each. That's 3 groups of 3 frescoes.
The riddle mentions 3 guides above the travelers. We must examine the frescoes, seek answers there.
I'll advise you about the riddle, but I will not take part in disarming the device. I've got a bad feeling about this.
What do you think of the first verse?
I would say it describes a serpentine dragon swallowing its own tail, which represents infinity and thus time. The hourglass likewise symbolizes time. In this case, the time of the traveler's journey.
I believe it's the dragon constellation. It would be visible at night. What's more, sources on alchemy invariably portray dragons as winged, and as an accomplished alchemist, Dehenna would also be a competent astrologer. The verse must refer to the constellation.
In alchemy, the winged serpentine dragon represents prime matter, an essential component in the process of alchemical transformation. The verse seems to indicate the allegory illustrating that transformation.
Everything seems to suggest the allegory of alchemical transformation.
I shall take that one.
What do you think of the second verse?
To my mind, it speaks of the white rose, symbol of the order of the flaming rose. You see, the fresco itself resembles a coat of arms, and in heraldry, silver is rendered as white. So the silver lady and white rose are one and the same.
I think it describes the full moon. In alchemy, the moon represents both silver as a metal and the feminine element.
The order remains largely unknown in the south, so the white rose seems unlikely. Every Nilfgaardian, on the other hand, has heard of the Imperial Nausicaa Brigade, which has the Death's Head as its symbol. The brigade's name is female, and they say death follows the unit. So the Silver Lady could very well be Nausicaa or the Death's Head.
I think it's the full moon.
Allow me.
What do you say to the third verse?
It describes the precipice, the ravine amidst mountains. An ancient rule in alchemy states, as above, so below. The vault is the ravine into which the riches of the mountain flow.
We must read the third line literally. To me, it suggests the Mahakam Mountains and its mines, from which dwarves and gnomes extract many ores that are invaluable to alchemists. Those mountains are a vault in and of themselves.
The verse is not literal. In many legends, towers are in fact vaults, which the hero must penetrate in order to rescue an imprisoned princess or find a long-concealed magic item. The mountain vault is the tower.
The verse describes the tower, I'm sure. I'll stand next to that fresco. Let's see if we can solve this. Take your places.
Count me out. I want to live.
As you will.